Rob's been moved to questionable. There's not a torn ACL. You know, it was just being assessed as a sprained knee.
So sometimes those are a month, 2 months. How long, because of his past knee injuries, could he miss?
Like I said, if you were talking about a regular guy, I'd probably put a timetable on it. But with Rob Bagg, you just don't know. That can go anywhere from 3 days to 3 weeks, you know. So it'll be day-to-day for us.
How ecstatic are you that that's all that it was?
I never went in tank, and that's what I told Rob. I was like, I didn't believe it, you know. So I'm glad it is what I thought it was, that, you know, maybe it was just a little scared for him.
What was his reaction?
Oh, he was in shock. You know, it still hadn't settled in yet, like I said. So as we continue to move forward and progress, we'll see how he works as far as him working out and doing everything and the pain tolerance and all those good things.
Were you thinking the worst?
Nope, did not think the worst. Was not.
Going to face the Edmonton Eskimos, they're coming off a game where they threw for 500 yards, or at least Mike Riley did. What are you seeing from them that may be a little different from your first time you played at the beginning of the season?
Well, he's matured. He's matured as a quarterback. You can see it. Like I said, he's I think I read one article. He said he was able to go through his fourth read, you know, and that's a lot of time, but he got through his fourth read. So that means that, you know, he understands the offense a bit more and that, you know, he's seen the field a bit more and understanding the defenses also.
What dangers does Fred Stamps bring into the fold?
Fred Stamps always bring the same danger. You know, he's a very explosive player, and if they're out of the game, he and Kerry Koch, as far as the receiving core, they're two young guys that can always change the game for him.
You seem to be doing a little more hands-on coaching. I remember it's at the start of the year you said you didn't want to, you know, be doing as much position coaching, but you've seen a little more of that this week. What's the theory behind that?
Sun's out, bored. Get tired of watching all the other coaches coach. They look like they have more fun than I do. That's pretty much it. And just really going back to my roots, just hanging out with the DBs and, you know, just teaching the fundamentals. That's the biggest thing for me, teaching the fundamentals, and it keeps me sharp also.
What are your thoughts about the deployment of G. Roy Simon so far in terms of production and going to him?
You know, G. Roy, you know, every day G. Roy does something, you know, whether it's in terms of actual play or in terms of him helping a younger player. You know, so G. Roy has been a plus for us. You know, like I said, we knew that he wasn't going to come in and be the number one receiver. He'd be a compliment, and I think there's some games when he's complimented and did a good job for us.
The combination of DBs on the same side of the field, when you look at Macho and Dwight Anderson, how important is it that they kind of can work as one, especially this week against a guy like Fred Stamps?
Well, you know, that's very important for those guys to have communication, you know, but with Fred Stamps, like I say, he's a very explosive player, but with those two guys on the weak side, you know, like I told Coach Richie earlier in the day, I said in the past, I've been in some games where I was pretty much worried. I said, you know, for the most part, you know, those guys are going to be at least a B-minus or better around Fred.
Kerry Johnson's still on 9-game, but you seem to be using him frequently in practice. What's the thought process of this weekend?
Well, it's a couple of things. If you look across our whole roster, it's not just him. You'll see a couple of guys that's on 9-game. Some guys that's on practice squad is the next up thing. Whoever's next up, you know, we have to be able ready to go because, you know, we're not worried about where they are on the roster. They're going to practice like they're the next up. If something happens, we don't have a problem if we have to move a guy from one part of the roster to the next.
Jock Sanders have to get it back together in practices rather in games?
Well, you know, Jock is like everyone else, you know. None of us want to mess up, but, you know, no matter who we are, we have some losses and some things that we've done, and we have to clean those up. Jock knows what he's done, and I think he's made some strides to clean it up.
When it comes to replacing Rob Bagg, if he's questionable, which player are you looking for at that side?
You know, it's a couple of different ways that we can shape the roster. So, you know, at the end of the day, what we're trying to do is wait to the end of the week, see who's the healthiest at the end of the week to make sure before we make any decisions. So it's a number of guys and a number of things that can happen depending on the health of the team.
Marcus Adams is here last couple of days. Just what is he doing here?
I asked the same question. no, just kidding. You know, it's one of those things where we talked to Marcus in the off season, and, you know, and I think he's doing some coaching here locally. So, you know, it's one of those things to where he wants to sharpen his skills, and it's always okay for ex-guys to come in and sharpen their skills.
Chris Best, is there a concern he may not play this week?
I don't have a concern for it. It's one of those things to where, you know, like everyone else, we usually rest on day one. He had the desire and pushed through day one, but he probably should have just been smart about it and took day one for rest and came back on day two.